I want to look at, with you at a real database. So far, we looked at Contoso. Contoso is a good demonstration database, but there are some details that are not visible in a database the size of Contoso. On a much larger model, we will be able to notice numbers that are evident on large models and that are totally irrelevant if we just look at demonstration databases. So let's start by looking at the first page of VertiPaq Analyzer. This model is a model that contains around 4 billion rows in the main fact table and several dimensions around it. The most striking aspect that appears is that the full database is around 18 gigabytes in size, and out of 17.8, 17.7 gigabytes are stored in one table only. So this is telling me that it is pointless to spend time analyzing all these tables because they represent a tiny fraction of the entire model. If any problem appears in a database of this size, it is likely to be in this table. All the remaining ones are basically pointless to analyze, or at least I don't spend a lot of time trying to optimize them. The main table contains not so many columns, contains a bunch of columns. I have the cardinality of each column, so the distinct values of the column, and the size. The column total size is the first number that I look at. There is typically a relationship between the cardinality and the size. So as long as the relationship is working fine, I know that I can try to reduce the cardinality, but there is not much more that I can do. Whereas in this case, there is an aspect which is interesting. Look at date. Date contains 1500 distinct values and uses 83 kilobytes in space. Look at time. It uses 1400 distinct values, so it's around the same cardinality as date, but it's by far the largest column of the entire model. So you go from 83 kilobytes to 6.4 gigabytes for 4 billion rows of two columns with the same number of distinct values. Here I have clearly either a problem with the sorting or with partitioning, or I might try to reduce cardinality to increase the duplicates, but I know that this is one of the most important columns that I need to work on in order to improve performance. All the remaining columns are just fine. Weight is a number, it has a large cardinality, but it's not the largest column. And I have this weight multiplied by age, 9.7 million distinct values, so this is a large column, and indeed it's using 4 gigabytes. If I'm interested in understanding more about this column, I can, for example, guess by the name that this is likely to be a calculated column, weight multiplied by age. I can quickly check if I go in the DAX expression, among the expression I find weight multiplied by age to discover the obvious. That is, this column contains the multiplication of weight times the age. Here, it is worth noting that weight is a column containing 2.6 gigabytes, age contains 165 megabytes, but the multiplication of the two is much, much larger. So it's worth asking ourselves whether it is good to waste 4 gigabytes of RAM to contain the result of a multiplication, or if it would be better to do the multiplication at runtime inside measures. I'm not saying that one choice is better than the other. It depends from a lot of different factors, but it's a point of attention that quickly comes out if you just look at the VertiPaq Analyzer data. When we look at the columns, you see that if we just stop on the first the columns that are more than 1 gigabyte in size, those columns alone use around 17.5 gigabytes of RAM out of a database of 18 gigabytes. So basically, the entire model is stored in these four columns. And if I need to work to try to reduce the size of this model or to optimize it, I know that these are the columns that I need to work on. What to do? Well, it depends. It depends on so many factors that we cannot enumerate them here, but at least I know where I need to work in order to find interesting information. Partition tells me the number of partition and the number of segments for each table. Again, there is nothing special about most of the tables, all these tables containing only one partition, and the only one that has multiple segments is the bridge table individual parameters, whereas audience, being the largest one, of course has around 60 partitions and 500 segments. What I look at here is typically the ratio between the segments and the partition to check that the model is not over-partitioned, which is not the case. Around 10 segments per partition is fine. There are no user hierarchies, and looking at the relationship, I typically look at the difference between from and to check that all the columns, all the values in the dimension are actually used in the fact table in order to make sure that there are no rows, no useless rows in the dimension, and this is not the case here. And I quickly look also at the size of the relationship to check that there are no relationships which are too large and might slow down the entire model. Compression tell me the number of bits used for different columns, and again there is nothing really interesting here, as there is nothing really exciting about the data type. When I look at data type, I typically look at whether the data type used by the engine are what I would expect, and I also look at the compression level that it achieved. Here we have a few strings, but the size is small. Most of the space is used by integers, and if I expand it, you can easily imagine that the columns that use most of the space are the ones that are used the most, so are the same ones that we saw earlier. Regarding encoding, you see that it used integers and strings, doubles and integer 64. And I also see the kind of encoding, the hash encoding or the value encoding. Now, hash encoding is totally good, and it's one of the choices that the engine can do. Hash encoding is absolutely fine if a column is involved in a relationship. You might think about changing from hash encoding to value encoding if you find columns that are largely used in mathematical operations. So I typically do this kind of analysis. I do not expect any of these columns in daytime or in strings, but in the integer, I find that the age, for which, of course, it makes sense to use hash encoding because it has a small number of values. I have all the columns which are part of the relationships, and then I have this weight and weight multiplied by age, for which the engine decided to use hash encoding. Now, I might question whether this is a good choice or not. And again, I'm not saying that the choice was wrong. I'm just saying that by a quick look at the database, a point of interest is whether using value encoding instead of hash encoding for this column might produce better performance. What I would need is add the hint, check the performance, analyze it, run the query test, do all my work, and only then I would be happy and satisfied. Finally, I typically look at the DAX expression in order to check the code which is written there. DAX expression is a good way to list all the DAX code which is in a model, to have it handy saved in an Excel file where I can analyze it to check the quality of the DAX code and the usage that developers decided to do with the columns. Again, there is nothing special, nothing worth further attention. But the point about this short demo was to demonstrate you the level of detail and the kind of information that you can retrieve from a database just by opening the VPAX file. It tells you a lot of information and gives you a lot of interesting hints on how to improve performance, reduce the model size, and obtain a better tabular model.